Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome to another card making video. Today I'm showcasing the latest die release by Altenew, and just like I did in the previous month, I'm going to share my three top favorites. They always have lovely products, making it super difficult to choose favorites, but I did my best. So let's take a quick look on them and then I'm going to share some projects. This is the lovely envelope die set, and it gives you a little envelope, the top and the bottom. You can have flowers or hearts coming out of the envelope. You can even create a little message and tuck it inside. I find this really versatile, can be used throughout the year for pretty much any occasion. Now, I picked one die set that has to do with flowers, lovely big flowers that look like watercolored ones. This would work great as focal points or to dress up a sentiment. And this set is called Painted Blooms. And I don't know about you, but I have a soft spot for alphabets. I absolutely love alphabet die sets. This is a lovely thin and tall one. It's called Mighty Alphabet. You can use it for initial cards. You can use it for customizing your very own sentiment. And also I like to use them on my art journals. As I'm making my cards today, I will throw in the mix some of other new die sets from the latest release so that you can see them in action, but my top three picks were those. So let's start with the first card, and I'm going to play with the envelope. I'm going to die cut pretty much everything from here, and with the magic of video editing, here are all the pieces ready to go. There are two different shapes of flowers in the set. I used just one of them, but I did die cut two layers for each flower just to make it look fluffier and more full. I did use a darker and a lighter shade for each of the flowers. So you can see here I have a darker yellow and a lighter yellow. And I'm just going to stick one on top of the other, slightly offset them so you can see the bottom layer better. And I do add a bit of dimension on the top layer. Now let's put the envelope together. I did die cut it from pale blue, and I'm using at the back thin foam strips to stick one on top of the other. Now if you want, you can use different shades of the same color for this envelope, so you can go darker for the back, which is going to give more depth. Now I am going to place one on top of the other, and at this stage you may want to add a little bit of glue at the bottom of your foam tape just to make sure that you will be able to slide them and make them stick nicely aligned. However, I didn't have any problems. You can see my little envelope is ready to go, and it is dimensional so that I can easily tuck inside all my bits and pieces. Now I have a little card panel here. I did die cut it using the mix and match frames. Now this is one of my all-time favorite die sets. I think it was released back in September or maybe earlier, and I like that it gives you all these layers so that you can easily create panels for your cards. And I usually pick the die that I'm using today with all those dots all around, or the other one that has that distressed look. So anyway, I'm going to stick the envelope on top of this panel, and I used glue for that, so it is going to lay flat. And then I'm going to play with all the die cuts. I did cut out leaves and branches out of different colors of green cardstock, just for some variation. So you will see I have lighter and darker green there. And I'm going to stick everything down. I'm just tucking it inside the envelope. And I alternate the different shades of green. And there are so many different variations for this card. If you want, you can go monochromatic or even add flowers instead of colored, silver or gold. These touches always make a card look more elegant. Another way to go would be, instead of having flowers and leaves coming out of the envelope, you can cut out a piece of paper that fits inside that envelope and just stamp the sentiment there. This set would work great to create a vintage looking card with an envelope that has a craft color and a brownish background with text. So many ideas. Probably this is my favorite from this release. So anyway, I'm sticking some hearts. There are also dies to cut out the center of the flowers. However, I decided to go with gems just to add some sparkle. And I'm also going to scatter a few of those gems coming out of the envelope. Any sentiment would work with this card. It can be used for any occasion. I just picked the one that says You Rock from the Way to Go die set, again from the latest release, so you can see this set in action. I just cut it out from white cardstock and back it up with black so that the words are more readable. And here are some close-up photos on the first card for today, and I find this die set just adorable. For my next card, I'm going to focus on the painted blooms, and I find that these are great fillers for dressing up big sentiments. So that's exactly what I'm going for today. I will use the Be Kind die set. This is from the latest release, but it would work with any big sentiments that you want to dress up. So again, with the magic of video editing, I do have all my pieces ready to go, and it's time for assembling. You can follow the directions at the back, but these are really very forgiving. Just stick one layer on top of the other and you are good to go. Nothing has to align perfectly there. These are very loose designed flowers. So for this card, I'm going with shades of blue and silver for the leaves. And when I do my die cutting, I always die cut way more than I actually need for the card, just to make sure that I have enough elements to play with, since I don't know from the beginning the full composition. And I was thinking of maybe having that smaller layer that is here lighter blue to cut it out from silver cardstock, which I did if you look at the top right corner. But finally I decided that it would be too much since I will have silver, glitter silver cardstock for the leaves and the sentiment. So the big flower is actually just three layers, one on top of the other, and then you get the buds where you get just two layers. They are really easy to put together, and think of all the different color combinations that you can do. Now for the sentiment, I did die cut the outline out of white cardstock, and I went with a glitter silver cardstock for the actual words. I'm going to stick one inside the other. For the background, I will go with white, so this is going to be white on white. It's going to give a very subtle look, however, it is going to give some dimension and help that sentiment stand out a little bit more. And since the background is going to be white, I'm going to add some visual texture there, again very subtle, by using my 3D embossing folder. One of my favorites are the ones that they don't give flowers or a specific design. I like 3D embossing folders when they give you a geometric pattern, so that you can pretty much use it in every card. And the one that I used here is the Diamond Stars, which I have used before in my cards, and it's one of my top favorites. So now here I'm taking my time. I'm using thin foam strips at the back of the sentiment, just because I want to pop it up. And you will see that although the outline is white, so you have white over white, it is visible and it does make a difference. In terms of design, when I dress up a sentiment, I like to use two corners. Just pick two opposite corners. I will go with the top one at the left and the bottom right. And if you are wondering, those tiny little stems were not included in the kit. I just used this cardstock and cut out a very thin strip with my scissors. Also, don't be afraid to separate the leaves. Nobody is going to see the bottom of them where you tear them apart. So here I was very pleased with how it looked, and I'm not going to use the extra flower that I had die cut. Now, although I did use glitter silver cardstock, I can never have enough shine, so I did add some gems, and here are some close-up photos. Now let's work with the alphabet, and I will share a couple of cards with this one just to show you two different takes. These are great to work with your pattern papers. Just look at your stars and find the pattern paper that you have. For this design, the busier the pattern paper, the better. Now, I'm browsing through the pattern papers from the Soft Washes paper pack, one of my favorites for sure. And it was so difficult here to pick a pattern, I loved each and every one of them, but finally I decided to use that one. Once you pick your pattern paper, cut it to size. I always like to cut out my panels to be slightly smaller than the standard card. So if the standard card is 4.25 by 5.5, I would go with 4 by 5.25. Then grab your alphabet and decide on the word that you want to create. And here in the beginning, I was going for hello, but then I am thinking that maybe I want to create a U, big U, so that I can combine it with another stamp sentiment, which is what I'm going for at the end. Take your time with aligning the letters on your panel. Make sure that you secure them down with some washi tape or low-tack tape. Also use a T-ruler to make sure that they are nice and straight, and then run them through your die-cutting machine. For this design, we are going with a negative, so we are going to use the actual panel, but you can always use the die-cut letters to create a second card. For this type of cards, always make sure that you keep the inside pieces to make your words more readable. I do have foam tape at the back, so this is going to give some shadows and dimension, making that word even more readable. And of course, I do have to add the inside piece again by using some foam tape so that it is nicely leveled with the rest of the word. And now, just a matter of combining this sentiment with another one. I did stamp "are amazing," so the whole phrase says "you are amazing." I stamped that with black ink on white cardstock and I cut it out with one of those sentiment dies. And of course, you can keep your card clean and simple and leave it as it is. Maybe add a few sequins to add some shine. However, I decided to embellish it a little bit more, again with the same idea of embellishing a big sentiment with flowers. So again, I used the painted blooms with the same pattern paper and I cut out the leaves and the flowers from different areas of that pattern paper. So I know that it matches perfectly with the colors of the background. And I also picked the smaller flowers from the die set that I haven't used in the previous card. So again, same design principle. I'm going to embellish the sentiment on the two opposite corners. I did add some gems at the center of the flowers, just like I usually do. And I also added a few white dots with my Nouveau drops. I always find that it gives kind of a whimsical look and feel on any card. So here is an easy idea on how you can use your alphabet dies with tiny flowers and use up your pattern papers. And I was planning to finish the video here, however, I couldn't stop myself. I'm going to share one more card just because it is super easy and it is the opposite idea of the last card that I shared. So here, again, I'm using pattern paper. Again, another great way to use alphabet dies with pattern papers. Here I picked one from the Celestial paper pack. Both my paper pads that I'm using today are old. These are from my stash and they are not from the latest collection. However, I believe they are still available. I will link them down below if you want to check them out. So a great way to use a big alphabet stamp is to combine it with another sentiment to emphasize one of the words. So here I picked the sentiment, "the sky is the limit," and I'm going to emphasize the word sky. So I'm going to die cut the three letters out of gold cardstock. And you see this time I'm going to actually use the die cut letters instead of their negative. Again, just like I did with the previous card, I cut out my panel to be slightly smaller than the standard card. And I made my card out of black cardstock, having a little black border all around. Now, when I'm using a black card base, I always make sure to stick inside a piece of white paper so that I can easily write my message. I'm sticking the letters down with the help of a T-square ruler. For the sentiment, you need to stamp it a couple of times, making sure that every time you mask off the part that you don't need. This way you will end up with the two parts of the phrase omitting the word sky, which I have replaced with the bigger letters. It's a quick and simple card to make, also great design to use up your pattern papers, and again, if you want to jazz it up a little bit more, you can add gems or a few stars. I did have these stars in my stash. And I also used my white Nouveau drops to emphasize some of the white stars from the background. And these were all the cards for today. I hope that you had fun and that you got inspired. Let me know in the comments below if you find sharing my top 3 favorites from releases helpful. Also keep in mind that this is part of a blog group. Make sure to visit my blog to find out all the info on how you can win prizes. Links to everything I used can be found below in the description area. Thank you all so much for joining me today. Don't forget to like the video and I'll see you all next time.